Hi, let us see 5th standard signal, exponential signals. In this 4 signals are there, that is e power of minus at u of t, e power of at u of t, e power of minus at u of minus t, and 4th one is e power of at u of minus t. So we Fourier transform, we applied this signal and this one, right? To these two we failed because it is not absolutely integrable. But Laplace transform will give solution for all 4 types of signals. So we know standard formula x of s equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power of minus st dt, right? So let us solve one by one. Here 4 signals I have drawn already. X of t e power of minus at u of t, this is exponential decaying signal, so it is absolutely integrable signal. Here x of t equal to e power of at u of t, exponential increasing signal, so it is not absolutely integrable. If we take area of this signal is will come infinity, right? And e power of minus at u of minus t also infinity area, and e power of at u of minus t is absolutely integrable signal. So Fourier transform, this we have solved, and for this also Fourier transform we solved, right? But Laplace transform will give solution for all 4 types of signal. So this is right side signal, this is also right side signal, this is left side signal, this is left side signal. So let us solve one by one. Here x of s equal to, so minus infinity to 0 is 0, right? So 0 to plus infinity we only we have, that is e power of minus at and e power of minus st dt, right? So if we integrate this signal 0 to plus infinity e power of minus s plus a t dt, right? So what is the integration of this one? E power of minus s plus a t by s plus a minus, right? Yes, 0 to plus infinity. Next, minus 1 by s plus a. Here e power of minus s plus a infinity minus e power of minus s plus a into 0, right? So this is s plus a, if it is greater than 0, then only this complete equation you can solve further. Otherwise, it will be become a infinity, right? So with this condition I am proceeding, then minus 1 by s plus a, this is 0 and this is minus 1, right? So 1 by s plus a, so what is the ROC here? S is greater than a, right? So here s means in this real part will be there, imaginary part. So a real part sigma greater than a, right? So here sigma and j omega, here minus a, right? So 0, 1, 2 and something minus a. So minus a greater than here, right? See, in this you can tell that ROC is included j omega axis. That means the signal is absolutely integrable. Next, let us solve this one. Same, x of s equal to 0 to plus infinity e power of at e power of minus st dt. So here x of s equal to 0 to plus infinity e power of a minus s t dt. So here e power of a minus s t by a minus s and limits are 0 to plus infinity. So x of s equal to 1 by a minus s. Here what will come? E power of a minus s into infinity minus e power of, this is 0, right? So here a minus s should be less than 0, right? If it is negative, then only you will get finite value. Otherwise, complete equation will be infinity, right? So that means a is less than s, that means s is greater than a, right? So then if you solve x of s equal to 1 by a minus s, this is 0, this is minus 1, so 1 by s minus a can write. And what is ROC for this? Here a you assume, so here this is, so right side signal will be having ROC right side, right? Both will be having ROC right side, right? and this included g of mu axis. This didn't include g of mu axis because it is not absolutely integrable. But still you have a Laplace transform with this condition. Next, let us see the x of t equal to e power of minus a t u of minus t. Here x of s equal to minus infinity to 0 we have, that is e power of minus a t e power of minus st dt. So x of s equal to minus infinity to 0 e power of minus, if I take common, a plus s t dt, and integration x of s equal to e power of minus a plus s t by minus a plus s, and limits are minus infinity to 0. X of s equal to minus 1 by s plus a, and this is e power of 0 minus e power of minus a plus s into infinity. So this complete equation should be exist, means a plus s should be greater than 0, right? That means s is greater than minus a. Here minus infinity, right? It will become plus. So this completely should be less than 0, right? So s less than minus a. So then if you solve further, x of s equal to this minus 1 by s plus a. This is 1 and this is 0. So answer is this one. And ROC is sigma g omega and minus a. It will be less than this side. So left side signal have a left side ROC, and g omega axis didn't include it because it is not absolutely integrable signal, right? Next, final one. So Laplace transform of this one is x of s equal to minus infinity to 0 e power of a t e power of minus st dt. So x of s equal to minus infinity to 0 e power of a minus s t dt, right? Then if you solve further, x of s equal to e power of a minus s t by a minus s minus infinity to 0, x of s equal to 1 by a minus s, this is e power of 0, and minus e power of a minus s minus infinity, right? So this term should not be infinity, means a minus s should greater than 0, right? That means s is less than a. Then x of s is 1 by a minus s and 1, right? This is 1. Or we can write this is minus 1 by s minus a, and ROC is sigma g omega, and this is a, assume. So left side signal will be hanging left side ROC, and also it included g omega axis, means it is a absolutely integrable signal, right? So now let us write conclusion. E power of minus a t u of t means right sided signal. Right sided signal 1 by s plus a will come. Here right sided signal only, positive only will come, s minus a. Here just a is replaced by minus a. Both are right sided signal. This is left sided signal, minus 1 by s plus a. Just a is replaced by minus a, minus 1 by s minus a. This is what we got answers. And ROC, this is right sided signal, so sigma greater than minus a, right? This is also right sided signal, sigma greater than a. Here p is a, right? This is left sided signal, sigma less than minus a. This is left sided signal, sigma less than a. So these are the conditions. Four signals you need to remember. Thank you.